Hello everyone, this is Sanchromi and together we will continue the course Interdisciplinary Approaches to Language and Its Use. In the previous 7 presentations, we focused on the sentence comprehension. Now we will turn our attention to a higher processing level, and this is discourse processing. We have already touched these issues when we discussed conversation and interactive alignment, and also when we focused on the role of contexts in sentence comprehension. Obviously, discourse processing has many similar features to sentence processing, but the research on discourse processing is often concerned also with other issues such as intersentential relations. From the beginning of the discourse processing research in psycholinguistics, researchers have been interested also in the role of memory, and another very interesting area of study is the study of inferences which bind a text together. The importance of memory and discourse comprehension is clear. To be able to understand what we read or what we listen to, we need to store the processed information in the long-term memory, and we need to be able to retrieve it again. Here we have the beginning of the novel Epsilon Epsilon by William Faulkner. I will give you a few seconds to read it yourself. As you can see, it is not easy to process this text, and we must put a lot of effort to understand it perfectly. We may ask many questions on how do we process such texts. One of the questions is, which information do we store in memory and which not? This question was already examined by Jacqueline Sachs in the 1960s. She presented participants audio recordings of short passages of texts, such as, "There is an interesting story about the telescope. In Holland, a man named Lippershey was an eyeglass maker. One day, his children were playing with some lenses. They discovered that things seemed very close if two lenses were held about a foot apart. Lippershey began experimenting and his spyglass attracted much attention. He sent a letter about it to Galileo, the great Italian scientist. Galileo at once realized the importance of the discovery and set about to build an instrument of his own. He used an old organ pipe with one lens curved out and the other in. On the first clear night, he pointed the glass towards the sky. He was amazed to find the empty dark spaces filled with brightly gleaming stars. Afterwards, she asked the participants whether they heard a certain sentence or not. Each participant had to say whether he or she heard one of these sentences. You can see that the meaning of sentences A, C, and D is the same, only word order or the syntactic properties are changed. However, the sentence B conveys a different meaning. Sachs found that the participants responded similarly to sentences A, C, and D, but only few agreed that they heard the sentence B. Galileo, the great Italian scientist, sent him a letter about it. Sachs thus interpreted the findings as an evidence that we stored primarily the meaning of the text, but not the form. Another issue in discourse processing are the inferences. They are very important for understanding because, thanks to them, we fill in the information which is missing in the text. Let's have a look at this example. The dog ran in the street, Brake screamed, and the tears came out. These sentences do not have any shared reference. They seem not to depend on each other. The only reason why we consider them as a part of a coherent text is that we use inferences which bridge the sentences based on our real-world knowledge. Gail McCune and Roger Radcliffe, in their study Inference During Reading, differentiate between the two types of inferences. On one hand, there are automatic inferences, which are based on easily available information, and they are necessary for local text coherence. On the other hand, they distinguish strategic inferences, which are based on certain goals and depend much more on our real-world knowledge and cultural practice. McCoon and Radcliffe argue that this distinction is not always clear-cut. It may be so that the strategic inferences in certain situations are the same as automatic inferences, and that some strategic inferences may be obligatory, in the sense that the text cannot be completely understood without them. Before we will conclude this presentation, I have one reading tip for you. If you are interested in discourse comprehension, I can recommend you to read a review article by Rolf Zwahn and David Rapp in Handbook of Psycholinguistics. If you enjoyed the presentations, we would be glad if you would like them on YouTube. That is all from me now. See you next time.